Two female suicide bombers have attacked a mosque in Gwoza, Borno State, killing 12-year-old boy and injuring 13 others. The female bombers tried to force their way into the mosque during the early morning prayers, reports say, before some community members raised an alarm. Some residents suspect that the suicide bombers might have infiltrated the town during a wedding which held at the palace of the emir of Gwoza on Saturday. Police authorities in the state confirmed that the area had been cordoned off as soldiers from 192 battalion have been deployed there. And joining us to discuss this still in the studio is security expert Ambassador Roy. Thank you for staying with us, sir.
Thank you very much.
And let's get talking about this. Now, what is the government not getting right as far as the defeat of Boko Haram is concerned? It seems the war is unending.
Well, we all know that the attacks have been persistent. We know that we have lost a lot of troops, a lot of gallant soldiers, Air Force personnel, and all that. We all know that. But one thing we are failing to see is the reclaiming of communities. Immediately, we push them a foot behind the scene. I expect that other agencies should take over those communities. I expect that the communities will be revitalized and people will engage activities, commercial activities, and that will help to also repolice the place, you know, and recapture the ground fully. So when you don't do that, you are leaving a lot of areas to be unpoliced, and there's opportunity for these people to regroup and to form new camps, you know. So one of that, and the closure of the border, you know, also help to reduce the proliferation of arms, you know. And then we are looking at a challenge of the troop motivation, because there's a lot of complaints from veterans that they are not being taken care of, and that will affect the serving personnel.
Yeah.
They will see that, okay, where am I going to if I leave this place, or if I die here, what will happen to my family? So it's a whole lot of approaches, you know, and we don't forget that the service chiefs, they have stayed a long time.
Yes.
You know, and, you know, people must get tired, and new ideas, new strategies need to be imputed, and others should be given opportunity to take over the helms of affairs.
All right. Now, we know that the federal government at severely said they've defeated Boko Haram, technically, that they've been defeated. But in the light of recent happenings and development, how do we reconcile this?
Well, the word technically, you know, it has caused a lot of this thing, uproar, yes, amongst the people, you know. But there is a war and there is a battle, you know. In a war, there are so many battles. You know, you can win so many battles and lose so many battles in the ongoing war. Terrorism is an ongoing war. The Western world are still fighting same scourge till date as we speak. So when we want to use the word technically, I think they are trying to portray that they have reduced the opportunity for Boko Haram to hold communities, hoist their flags, and gain supply of weaponry, supply of finance.
Yes.
They are trying to reduce their opportunities, you know. But I think that that should just be like, we have won this war, or we have won this battle, or this battle, because the war goes on, and you cannot fully say that you have captured all their opportunities and reduced their striking capabilities.
Ambassador Roy Ohideve, once again, thank you very much for
your
contribution and news on the hour.
Yeah.